Good morning, guys. Are you getting my voice? See, previously we have seen the Google file system. Now we have to see another one concept called the Hadoop. Clear? So basic point about the Hadoop is Hadoop purely developed basing on the concept of Google file system only. Hadoop was developed. Google file system was developed for the internal working of its own applications of Google. Google people developed Google file system for their internal own applications only. And basing on the concept of the Google file system, Hadoop was developed by the Apache people. Hadoop was developed. Okay. And when we come to this Hadoop, the first point is Hadoop is an open source framework. When we come to the Hadoop, Hadoop is an open source framework. Okay. What is open source means? It is a freely available software. Anybody can happily download a Hadoop software from the internet and they can use the Hadoop. It is a free software. It is not a commercial software. The Apache Foundation has developed this Hadoop as a open source software only. So when we come to the Hadoop is an open source framework. Open source means it is freely available software. Next, framework means, okay, the Hadoop is also similar to Java collection framework. Hadoop is also a collection framework. That means collection of some machines will form this Hadoop. It is not a single device or single entity. It is a collection. Okay, when we come to previously in the first unit, we have seen Java collection framework. Java collection framework means, collection framework means generally what is the meaning of framework? Readily available things are called framework. Okay, is readily available for uses are called the frameworks. For example, flexible frames and quantity 6x4 size flexible frame ready ga untundi. Just then mana frame ready ga untundi eppudu ga ante appudu flexi dani paste chestuntam ok kotta flexi pettali aa frame ki add attach chestam where next day ingo flexi pettali simple aa flexi tisesi aa frame ki idu pettukunta undi. Okay, ante frame is readily available aa frame ni mana eppudu ga ante appudu use chesukochu. Similarly, Java collection framework means, okay, set of classes are available in Java which are readily useful. Okay, man already konni chusam andi first unit lo we have seen stacks, linked list, queues, sets, maps, data structures yokka classes chusam. They are readily available classes and interfaces. Simply stack create cheyali, mana logic raalsina avasaram ledhu, ready ga stack class unda class use chestuntamu. Queue raayali, develop cheyali, we have no need to write for the queue. Simply we use the queue interface to create a queue. Link list create cheyali, we use the link list class. Set create cheyali, we use the set interface. Okay, readily available classes. Okay, Java is a collection framework. That means it contains readily available classes and interfaces are available for doing things. Okay, Java contains data structure frameworks. Okay, structs, Hibernate, applets. Okay, and when we come to this one, Hibernate, structs, all those things are the collection frameworks. They are readily available collection frameworks are there. Similarly, Hadoop is also a framework. That means readily available. Okay, how to use that one only. Okay, the Hadoop software is a open source framework, means readily available software which is ready to use. The organization, the people can happily download the Hadoop and they can readily use that one. We have nothing more to write the code. Simply we download, you install Hadoop and we can happily use that one. It is a readily available software. That's why Hadoop is called as a open source framework, freely available and readily available software. Clear? This Hadoop was first was developed by Dov Cutting and his team. Okay, basing on the papers published by the Google people on GFA, Dov Cutting and his team of Apache Foundation has developed this open source project Hadoop. Clear? And this Hadoop is completely written in the Java language and it is not like OLAP, online analytical processing. What is this online analytical processing? Online analytical processing is a multi-dimensional analysis processing. It is a multi-dimensional analysis processing. I think you got this OLAP in your DWDM. Okay, this Hadoop is not similar to that one. Okay, Hadoop is completely written in the Java. When we come to this Hadoop, clear? The Hadoop will do two things. People will use the Hadoop mainly for two works. One is storing of their files. The first use of the Hadoop is people will use the Hadoop mainly for two things. One is for storing their files, and the second one is for processing their files. That means to process or analyze their data, to store data. Hadoop is used by the people. Two kinds of people will approach the Hadoop. Okay, one is, one type of people is they want to store their huge files. We have huge amount of files or data is there. Okay, since I'm unable to store my huge amount of data in my local system, I will approach Hadoop for storing of the huge volumes of data. The first use of the Hadoop is to store the huge volumes of data. One kind of people who don't have sufficient storage to store their huge volumes of data, they will approach the Hadoop, okay, for storing of their huge volumes of data. The second category of people are there, where who want to process the data fastly. Okay, for these people, the data may be small or big, but they want the processing of data fastly. So for the purpose of fast processing of the data, they will approach the Hadoop. For the second category people, the data may be small or big, okay, but they want the processing of the data very fastly. They want analysis of data very fastly. They want to analyze the data. They want to process the data very fastly. For that purpose, they will approach the Hadoop. So Hadoop is used for mainly two purposes: storing of the huge volumes of data, fast processing of the volumes of data. Clear? That's why, that is the reason why we are approaching the Hadoop, why people are going for means. Simply in one line, what is the use of Hadoop means? Hadoop has two uses: for storing of huge volumes of data, and first for fast processing. Here processing will be very fast. We will see later how the processing is fast, how it is going on later. We will see. Clear? For those two reasons, people will approach this Hadoop. Clear? These are those basic 2 points about the Hadoop. For storing of the huge volumes of data, that means large files, for storing large files, we approach Hadoop. For processing the data fastly also, we will approach the Hadoop. Clear? When we come to this Hadoop, Hadoop mainly contains two components. When we come to the Hadoop, Hadoop has majorly two components are there in the Hadoop. The first component is HDFS. One main component of the Hadoop is HDFS. What is this HDFS? Hadoop Distributed File System, HDFS. The second component of the Hadoop is MapReduce. There are two main components in case of the Hadoop. They are the, one is the HDFS, the other one is the MapReduce. What is this HDFS? The concept of HDFS is similar to GFS. If you know about GFS, then it is similar to that of this one. Hadoop Distributed File System is also basing on the concept of distributed file systems only. Hadoop distributed file system is also basing on the concept of the distributed file system only. Clear? When we come to the HDFS will be there, and as well as the HDFS is mainly distributed file system. What is this distributed file system? Okay, Hadoop has two main components. One is HDFS and the other one is the MapReduce. When we come to this HDFS, it is named the indicator distributed file system. That means it will follow the architecture of client server architecture. It will follow a concept of client server architecture. Okay, every time we have to know clearly about the distributed file system. What is this concept of distributed file system means? One more time repeating. The file, the data will be placed in some server systems. And whenever the client wants, the client will approach the server system for accessing the data. The data in case of DFS, distributed file system, data will not be stored in the client system. The client will not store data in his own systems. He will store the data in server systems. And whenever he wants to access his data, he will approach the server and he will access the data. That is the distributed file system. Okay, the data will not be in the client system. They will be in the server system. So the clients will approach the server system for accessing the data. That is the concept of distributed file system. Here the architecture is client server architecture. Our Hadoop is all HDFS is also following the distributed file system concept only. Clear? Here already we said what are the two main uses of the Hadoop. Hadoop is used for two services. One is for storing of the file huge volumes of data. The other one is for fast processing of the data. One service is storing, the other service is processing the data. When we come to these two components, the first component HDFS is for storing. The use of this HDFS is only for storing. We use the component HDFS. For processing the data, we use the component MapReduce. For storing the data, HDFS is used, and for processing the data, MapReduce is used. These two components are used for two services given by the Hadoop, that is storing and processing. HDFS component and MapReduce component of the Hadoop will be used. Okay, now we have to briefly see about the HDFS, then we will go for the MapReduce. Is it, guys? Are you following? Okay. See, now we are coming to this one, HDFS. HDFS can be defined as a special file system. See the definition, important one. In one line, we can easily define the HDFS. A special file system with the cluster of commodity hardware with stream access pattern. See, how can we simply in one line, how can we give the entire HDFS means a Hadoop distributed file system is a special file system with cluster of commodity hardware with stream access pattern. It is a special file system with cluster means group. Okay, with the cluster means group. With a cluster of commodity hardware, okay, with a group of cheaply available machines. It is a specially designed file system with a group of cheaply available machines. The compound, the machines we are using in this cluster are not so much costly machines. They are only the cheaply and frequently available machines only. Okay, it is a special file system with a cluster of commodity hardware. Cluster means group. The terminology we are using here is a Hadoop is a cluster of commodity hardware. That means commodity hardware means cheap and inexpensive hardware components. Clear? With stream access pattern. It is a special file system with a cluster of commodity hardware with stream access pattern. Is it clear, guys? First, what is this cluster of commodity hardware in the definition? What is this cluster of commodity hardware? Is it clear? Cluster of commodity hardware means group of inexpensive component. Okay, the whatever the computer machines we are using in that one is a cheaply available inexpensive components we are using. The hard disk we are using, the processors we are using, everything are there. We are using in that one are the cheaply and inexpensive components only we are using. Okay, here in the definition, one point we have to clear is up to this one is clear. What is this stream access pattern? HDFS is a special file system with a cluster of commodity hardware with the stream access pattern. What is the stream access pattern is? Clear? See, okay, before going to this one, we will come back to Java. In Java, there is a line is there. One slogan or line is there. Write once, run anywhere. Did you hear about that line in Java, about Java? Write once, run anywhere. Around when are and is Java going to point to? Run anywhere. And then meaning in Java lo, once you write the program on any system, oka platform with a program raste, we can run that program in any platform. Okay, once we write the program in Java, we can write the run the same program in any platform. Why? Because Java is a platform independent. So for Java, the slogan is write once, run anywhere. Similar to that statement, in HDFS also, there is a line is there. Write once, read any number of times, but don't try to modify the data file. Don't try to modify the file. Write once, read any number of times, but don't try to modify the file. Okay, that is the stream access pattern, meaning is nothing but write once, read any number of times, but don't modify. What is this HDFS is saying is, okay, in this file system, please store the file once. Okay, write data to the HDFS once and read any number of times. Okay, write the data to the HDFS once, read the file any number of times, but don't try to modify the data. That is the slogan that is used by this one. Clear? Stream access pattern means the meaning of the motto of that stream access pattern is, okay, write the data any number, write once. That means write the data to the file system once, but you can read the data any number of times. You can access the data for read operation, but don't try to modify. That is the stream access pattern. Okay, we can call this one as the stream access pattern, means write the file once, read the file any number of times, but don't try to modify the file. Is it clear, guys? Stream access pattern. We can call this one as the stream access pattern or motto of this HDFS. What it is saying is, please, number of times, don't try to modify the file. Clear? That is the thing. And HDFS can be defined as a special file system with the cluster of commodity hardware with a stream access pattern. With a stream access pattern. Stream access pattern means simply we can say it as write once, read any number of times. Okay, that is the thing about this one. Is it clear, guys? The definition, single line one. What is this HDFS? First of all, is it clear, guys? The name, meaning, cluster of commodity hardware with stream access pattern. What is this one? Now see, when we come to this one, up to this part is okay. Now we have some meaning about cluster of commodity hardware with stream access pattern. Now we got some rough idea about what is stream access pattern, what is cluster of commodity hardware. Why HDFS is a special file system? Why it is calling as a special file system? What is the specialty in that one, in that Hadoop distributed file system? What is that specialty? Why he is calling that one as a special file system? Okay, before knowing the specialty of the HDFS, we will come back to our normal file system in our systems. In our system, where we store the files, in our system, where we store our data, in your laptop or desktop, where you store the data, data files, whether audio files, video files, or anything, where we store them. Exactly, we store our data files in the hard disk. In our system, we use the hard disk. More generally, we use the 500 GB, okay, 250 GB, like that. Nowadays, people are using 1 TB data GB, 1 TB hard disk directly. They are storing their files in the hard disk. Okay, whether hard disk, how hard disk has got the capability of storing files, how hard disk got the capability of storing files, can hard disk directly store the files? See, when we come to this hard disk, directly hard disk does not have the capability of storing the files. That means directly hard disk is not a file system. It does not have the capabilities to store the files. Okay, by installing OS in your system, OS is giving the hard disk the capability of storing the files. OS is making the hard disk as a file system. Okay, on the top of the hard disk, OS is there. With the OS only, when our OS is installed in your system, then your hard disk is changed as a file system. It is able to store the files. Your hard disk is able to store the files only when OS is there in your system. Clear? With the help of the OS, your hard disk is capable of storing the files. Is it clear, guys, this point? With the help of the operating system, our hard disk is capable of storing the files. Now, internally, how it will store the files in the hard disk, internally how it will store the files means. ఈ టేబుల్ మార్జిన్స్ కనపడుతున్నాయండి అదర్వైజ్ సి వెన్ వి కమ్ టు దిస్ హార్డ్ డిస్క్ డు యు నో ద ఇంటర్నల్ స్ట్రక్చర్ ఆఫ్ హార్డ్ డిస్క్ ఎప్పుడైనా చూసారా ఇంటర్నల్ స్ట్రక్చర్ ఆఫ్ హార్డ్ డిస్క్ డిడ్ ఎనీబడి హావ్ ఎనీ ఐడియా అబౌట్ ద ఇంటర్నల్ స్ట్రక్చర్ ఆఫ్ హార్డ్ డిస్క్ See, if you take this one as your hard disk, okay, first what will happen is the hard disk will be divided into partitions with the help of the sectors. I think in the internal structure of, if you take internal structure of the hard disk, okay, the hard disk is divided into the total hard disk divided into the partitions. These lines are called the sectors. These lines are called as the sectors. By using the sectors, the hard disk is divided into the partitions. Okay, each partition is called a block. We call this particular partition as a block. One block, second block, third block, fourth block, like that. Okay, internally the hard disk will be divided into a partitions with the help of sector. The lines are called the sectors. By okay, the hard disk will be divided into partitions. What is the size of each partition in the hard disk is 4 KB. The size of each partition in the hard disk is 4 KB. Clear, guys? The size of each partition will be 4 KB. Are you following? Okay, the hard disk is internally divided into the partitions, all the blocks. The size of each block is 4 KB. In case of hard disk, the size of each block is 4 KB. So whenever we want to store a file in the hard disk, first the file will be divided into blocks. Okay, for example, you want to store 10 KB file in your hard disk. The size of each block in the hard disk is 4 KB. So how many blocks will be there in your file? First, the file will be divided into 3 blocks. Since your file size is 10 KB, first file, part 1, 4 KB, part 2, 4 KB, part 3, 2 KB. Okay, those three files will be stored in the three blocks. Three parts of the file will be stored in three blocks. So first part, second part, and third part. Like that, we will store. Okay, in the normal file system, the hard disk is divided into the partitions called blocks, where the size of each block is 4 KB. And whenever you have a file, the file will be divided into the number of partitions. Okay, basing on its size, 4 KB, 4 KB parts will be divided, the file will be divided into partitions, and each partition will be stored in one block. Is it clear, guys? Here, for example, you have a file of 2 KB. How many part blocks are required for that one? Whenever you have a file of 2 KB, how many blocks are required for that one? Only one block is required for the 2 KB file. No need to partition the file. Why? Because the block size is 4 KB. So only one block is sufficient. So we store that file in that first block. One block is allocated for that file and it will be stored. Okay, is there any empty space in that block still? After storing the 2 KB file, still 2 KB empty space is there in that block. Clear? What about this 2 KB in empty space? Can we reuse that one for some other file? Can we reuse that empty space? See, we have a 4 KB block, but my file size is 2 KB. So I place the 2 KB file in that block. Remaining still 2 KB space is there in that block. 2 KB space is there. Can I reuse the 2 KB remaining space in that block? No, yes, we can't reuse that one. We call this type of wastage of memory is called what type of, there is a name in your OS for this type of wastage of data. What is that name? OS లో మనకు ఒక నేమ్ ఉందండి ఈ టైప్ ఆఫ్ వేస్టేజ్ ఆఫ్ మెమరీకి ఐ థింక్ ఇన్ ద OS యు గాట్ దిస్ వన్ ఒక పార్టీషన్ లోపల మెమరీ మిగిలిపోయి వేస్ట్ అయితే దానికి ఒక నేమ్ ఉంది మనకి కెన్ ఎనీబడీ హావ్ ఐడియా అబౌట్ దట్ వన్ గుర్తుందండి ఇంటర్నల్ ఫ్రాగ్మెంటేషన్ ఎక్స్టర్నల్ ఫ్రాగ్మెంటేషన్ కాన్సెప్ట్స్ ఒక పార్టీషన్ లోపల మన మెమరీ మేనేజ్మెంట్ లో వచ్చి ఉంటుంది మీకు ఓఎస్ లో ఓకే ఒక పార్టీషన్ లోపల కనుక స్పేస్ మిగిలిపోతే దాన్ని ఏమంటాము ఇంటర్నల్ ఫ్రాగ్మెంటేషన్ దట్ మెమరీ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి వేస్టెడ్ దాన్ని మనం రీయూజ్ చేసుకోలేము సో హియర్ వన్ పాయింట్ ఈజ్ అది క్లియర్ కదండి ఇంటర్నల్ ఫ్రాగ్మెంటేషన్ ఐడియా ఉంది కదా వెన్ వి కమ్ టు దిస్ వన్ ఓకే ద ఫస్ట్ పాయింట్ అబౌట్ ద హార్డ్ డిస్క్ ఈస్ వి ఆర్ స్టోర్ ద హార్డ్ డిస్క్ ఈస్ పార్టీషన్ ఇన్ టు 4KB బ్లాక్ అండ్ వెన్ ఎవర్ దెర్ ఈస్ అ ఫైల్ లెస్ దాన్ 4KB internal fragmentation will be there internally the remaining space in the block will be wasted that is the one more point next for example if I want to store 1GB file my movie size is 1GB how many blocks are required for that one how many partitions the file will be made 4KB partitions enna avuta enna file so many number of 4 partitions will be there 1GB file store chestunnam ante so many partitions will be there clear so నాకు ఆ మూవీ ప్లే అవ్వాలి అంటే ఈ మెమరీ హార్డ్ డిస్క్ లో ఉన్న అన్ని పార్టీషన్స్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ వదిలేయాలి ఓకే సో ఇట్ హ్యాస్ టు మెయింటైన్ ద ఓఎస్ హ్యాస్ టు మెయింటైన్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ అబౌట్ సో మెనీ పార్టీషన్స్ ఏ పార్టీషన్ ఏ బ్లాక్ లో ఉంది ఆ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ మొత్తం ఓఎస్ నోట్ చేసుకోవాలి క్లియర్ ద ఆపరేటింగ్ సిస్టమ్ హ్యాస్ నోట్ డౌన్ విచ్ బ్లాక్ పార్టీషన్ ఈజ్ ఇన్ విచ్ బ్లాక్ మనకు 10KB ఫైల్ కే 3 పార్టీషన్స్ వచ్చాయి 3 బ్లాక్స్ కాబట్టి ఓఎస్ నోట్ చేసుకుంది ఓకే దిస్ పర్టికులర్ 10KB ఫైల్ ఇస్ ఇన్ బ్లాక్ ఏ బ్లాక్ బి బ్లాక్ సి అదే మీ వీడియో కనుక 1GB ఫైల్ అయితే మీ డేటా కనుక 1GB అయితే సో మెనీ బ్లాక్స్ ఆర్ రిక్వైర్డ్ ఆటోమేటిక్గా ఓఎస్ విల్ హ్యావ్ టు మెయింటైన్ ఆల్ ద డీటెయిల్స్ ఓకే జనరల్ గా ఆ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ మనం ఏమంటాము ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ అబౌట్ ద బ్లాక్ ఓకే ఇన్ విచ్ బ్లాక్ వి స్టోర్డ్ ద పార్టీషన్స్ ఆ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ మనం ఏమంటాము ఇట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ద మెటా డేటా జనరల్ వి కాల్ ఇట్ యాజ్ ఏ మెటా డేటా since for 4KB party blocks we are using the number of partitions of the data file will be more so OS has to maintain a huge amount of metadata 1GB file ki chala 4KB blocks kavali alanti 4KB block aa information mottham OS maintain cheskovali okay the metadata size will be increased clear is it clear guys hard disk is working as a file system with the help of OS hard disk is internally divided into blocks of 4KB size fixed size partitions of block 4KB size so whenever we are storing the file in that blocks okay the file will be partitioned into the 4KB size and they will be stored in those blocks sometimes there is a chance of getting internal fragmentation here next point is the metadata size will also be increased very much whenever you have a large file like 1GB 2GB or 10GB the metadata will also increase huge clear that is what is happening in the normal file system is it clear briefly about the normal file system in our local systems is it okay guys metadata will be very high when file size is increased there is a chance of getting internal fragmentation clear and points metadata will increase there is a chance of getting the internal fragmentation also that is about the word normal file system is it clear guys intavarku okay nandi guys if you give the proper response then only we can happily move forward I have to get the point whether you are getting the points or not if you don't respond how can I understand otherwise simply I have to talk like a robot without confirming whether you are getting or not so that no use at all the concept will be over but I don't know whether you reached those points or not see clear that is what is happening in the ordinary file system the files here the important is 4KB part blocks are there there is a chance of getting internal fragmentation
and metadata will be very high. Now, when we install Hadoop on our system, already we said Hadoop is a special file system. How it is special file system means when we install Hadoop on our system, the hard disk will be partitioned into blocks of 64 MB blocks instead of 4 KB blocks. Okay, the hard disk will be partitioned into 64 MB blocks. The Hadoop will partition the hard disk into 64 MB blocks. Is it clear, guys? Actually, original size of the block is normal file. Hard disk blocks are 4 KB partitions will be there. 4 KB blocks will be there. When we install Hadoop, it will partition the hard disk into 64 MB blocks. Clear? That is the first thing. Normal hard disk has 4 KB blocks. When we install Hadoop on that one, it will contain the 64 MB blocks will be there. That is the first thing. Next thing is, in case of Hadoop, for example, your block size is 64 MB. I have a file of 65 MB size file is there. So how many blocks are required for the 65 MB? Two blocks are required. First block will take total 64 MB. What about the second block of 64 MB? Only 1 MB space will be used. How much remaining space is there? 63 MB space is available in that one. In case of Hadoop, if there is any empty space in the block, we can reuse that block space for other files. Clear? There is no chance of internal fragmentation in case of Hadoop file system. Whenever there is an empty space inside the block, happily we can use that space for other files also. In case of normal partition in the hard disk, there is no chance of reusing. That will go as an internal fragmentation, but there is no chance for internal fragmentation in case of HDFS. Clear? That is the second point. Next one, we come to the metadata. Previously, 1 GB file is there. If you partition as 4 KB partitions, lot of metadata will be there. If you make it as 64 MB partitions, the metadata will also reduce. Okay, the metadata of the file will also be reduced if you make a big partition of 64 MB instead of 4 KB. If you make a partition of 64 MB, the metadata will also be reduced. Clear? See, normal file system problems are the chance of getting internal fragmentation. Part block size is 4 KB. There is a chance of internal fragmentation. Metadata size will be increased. When we go for Hadoop distributed file system, the block size is 64 MB. There is no chance of getting internal fragmentation. Next, metadata will also be reduced. The size of metadata will also be reduced. That is the basic things. Is it clear, guys? Whenever we install Hadoop on our system, when we install the Hadoop, the advantage is the HDFS will block size is 64 MB. And there is no chance of getting internal fragmentation. And there is the metadata will also be reduced. That's why we call this HDFS as a special file system. Okay, on our top of the hard disk, we are installing Hadoop so that your hard disk, okay, we are changing the properties of the normal file system. That's why HDFS is called a special file system. Now, is it clear, guys, this concept? HDFS is a special file system with a cluster of commodity hardware with a stream access pattern. In one line, we can give that one as this one. Yeah, and HDFS is a special file system with a cluster of commodity hardware with a stream access pattern. It is a special file system. Why? Because its block size is 64 MB and there is no chance of getting any internal fragmentation. Metadata will also be reduced. And it is a cluster of commodity hardware. It is a group of cheap and inexpensive hardware components. With a stream access pattern means its slogan is write once, read any number of times, but don't try to modify the file. This is briefly the basic thing, introduction about this HDFS. Is it clear, guys, this point? If it is clear, then in the next class tomorrow, we will learn about what are the components of HDFS. Inside the HDFS, who are present inside the HDFS, how they are storing the data, how they are processing the data. We will see them in the next class. Clear? This is briefly the basics of the HDFS, introduction about the Hadoop distributed file system and comparison of HDFS with R.